Building a sturdy bridge requires the right materials and the right structures. But today, we're going to learn and see how bridge failure can be just as important as learning what makes a bridge successful. Let's go bust some bridges. What's happening here?
Basically, high school students from across Indiana and Illinois are building balsa wood bridges out of wood glue and balsa wood, and now we're breaking them on the tables behind me. We send them a package in January with balsa wood and glue. They can only use those materials to build the bridge. So then they come here today with a completed bridge, and we weigh them, we judge them based on the rules, making sure that the correct height, dimension, that kind of stuff. Then they go on the breaking tables. The winner is based on the efficiency of the bridge. The winners usually can hold up to 40 or 50 pounds, which is pretty remarkable considering they're only about a pound, the bridge itself. A way to test any bridge is to test its failure. You always design for the failure of the bridge, not just for its aesthetics and for just that it looks pretty. So right now they're learning what it takes to fail. Well, I think the students are getting out of this event a lot of engineering concepts, basic fundamentals of engineering, why things fail, what looks good. I mean, obviously a bridge does need to be aesthetically pleasing as well. So that kind of stuff, but also it's a really fun event. They've put a lot of hard work into these bridges, and so seeing them fail, seeing how they fail and watching the pieces fly up and just knowing how well they did.
Well, bridge failures for young people like this, it's really important for them to gain an appreciation for failures in that we learn a lot from them, right? So if we can learn why something failed, then we can change how we design things in the future, in this case bridges, and we learn how not to have these things happen. We learn to have safer, more reliable, more robust structures. And I always enjoy being here because it's nice to be able to share some of the things we've worked on, trying to motivate young people into a career like this and to be able to excite them into engineering, and in this case, bridge engineering.
I think these kids are really competitive because they spend a lot of hours in these bridges, so they want to see how well they can do, and you'll see a lot of competitive kids and some great bridges too.
It took me a while to build. It took me, I think, about 10 hours. Yeah. The bows were the longest thing because I had to get them wet, and it took them like 2 days to dry. The reason I went through the trouble of bending them was to have more strength in my bridge. It was kind of interesting to walk in, and at first there didn't seem to be very much of anybody, but then everybody started showing up, and it was like, oh my gosh, you look at all these different bridges. And then you see all the different designs that people make. Like, mine might have been like somebody's, but they were all pretty much all like different.
So, are you guys excited about being here today?
Oh yeah, it's just amazing. This is our first time out here, and we love it. It's great, all these bridges and everything, and how intense the designs are, and how strong everything looks. It's great.
Actually, it's beyond what we were expecting. Yeah. It's way beyond. Like, this part didn't break at all. It's the left part, but the right part broke a lot. So I think we didn't break the bridge evenly. Like, it didn't stand flat. Mm-hmm. So I think that's a problem. Like, just make sure next time make it better perfectly.
Today has been another great example of learning what not to do is just as important as learning what to do. For Boiler Bytes, I'm Keith Brashper.